indicate the world has a history of 5.6 billion years or 6.5 billion years ago that the wind that we can hit. So ever since there has been change. Not an iota has passed where there is no observed change. Things are developing all through their perfection or near perfection. They are traveling. Nothing is stationary. And complexity is born out of simplicity. So if complexity is not guarded, it can turn into simplicity. It disintegrates. But for simplicity to turn into complexity is a very important scientific observation. Because it's an uphill task. And the uphill task requires energy from outside. The input is always greater than the output. And it's never so that output is greater than the input. So it's impossible. If there is input of some sort, and organization is input, if from simplicity, the creation is traveling towards complexity, and you observe organization, then there has to be some organizer. Now, when we say, alright, if there has to be an organizer, who organized God, you say you don't know. Because unless you know the facts, you can't raise the question. Now, one thing you can be certain, that this universe is not eternal. And because it is not eternal, there has to be something preceding it. And that may be eternal. And there is no argument against eternity. This is why I started with the question of eternity. Ultimately, it will end up there. If you absorb the whole thing, this is how it develops again. That simplicity, complete simplicity, such simplicity as the whole laws of science are non-operative at that stage, when there is before the Big Bang. There is no law of nature, this is called event horizon. There is nothing at all. No physical law, no chemical law, no other law of operation. So it is nothingness. In other words, this is what we call nothingness. We say Allah created from nothingness. In the scientific terminology, nothingness means a thing without property. Now when you say something without property, that thing disappears. It's only a word of necessity you have to use for something. Otherwise, without property means nothing. Everything in existence has to have a property. Some measurement, some mass, some radiation or anything. I mean observable phenomena is called property. Or which exudes itself. So the scientists believe, and they have positive evidence now, that at the time of Big Bang there were no properties. So the properties began to change ever since. And developed from simplicity to complexity. And that complexity had a direction. It was not a half-headed affair. It was a direction which it took. And that direction developed into complex scientific laws. And those complex scientific laws agreed with each other. And so much so that when a law was created, and if that law as such operated, there might have been no chance left for life to operate, then an exception was made to that law. In such detail, things were worked out. For example, when things become hot, they expand. And they, when they become cold, they contract. This is a general law. But in water, if it had acted exactly like that, there would have been no life. So an exception was made there. When the ice is made, it expands. Why? Because it was necessary for life. So there was nothing of blindness about him, no element of blindness about him. There is purpose, there is direction, there is government, and complete organization and full control of all the things. Now, why life could not have existed if this law was operated that when you eat it, things expand, when you eat them, things expand, when you apply force, they contract. Because the scientists say that when life took root in the oceans, if ice also contracted, what would have happened that the surface ice would have settled down until the whole sea would have turned into ice. And there was absolutely no question during that climate of any warmth within the sea. Hence, the possibility of life was created. So what happened was, there was an exception made. Ice must expand when it becomes cold. Cold water, cold for cold, and when water is cold enough, it must expand. So when it expands, it comes to the surface. And also, when it's a law that water turns into ice and it back conducted by heat. Which means, once the whole surface of the sea is covered with thick ice, even if the temperatures outside are -100 degrees, the temperature below that would remain enough and comfortable for life. That is a protective effect. So there are thousands and thousands of examples, I can go on and on, where this phenomenon of organization can be explained in this manner. As it is impossible for anyone, any scientist, to come out with the always repeated answer of chance. After all, there is some limitation to chance. Chance does not mean that for unlimited numbers of chances it is possible to come and organize one after the other in a procession, an unending procession of that matter. So this is what I mean by organization. When there is organization and simplicity is tending towards complexity, then there has to be an organizer. And if that organizer is eternal, then no objection, scientific objection to that. Because anything can be eternal. If he is not eternal, then this universe has to be eternal. So from eternity there is no escape. So if the organizer is eternal, then the circle, vicious circle, will immediately grow. We know the universe, this is organized, but we don't know the creator, whether he was organized or not like that from eternity. So there is no objection, no scientific objection. This is how we can prove the existence of God to the atheist. At least to the extent that they can't mock at you, they can't laugh at you, that you're stupid and you're behaving in others, is not, cannot survive in another way. No, this is wrong. The scientists are now turning into theists at a rapid rate, with the result that previously, 50 years ago, when the census was taken in America, the entire crop of scientists had not only become atheists, but thought they were nothing. It was the beginning of their nothing and they had become powerful. It was considered a shame to mention religion. They thought religion is just focus and science is science. That's the reality. Now the recent consensus is strong that 50% of the scientists in the world today have become theists. They believe in God. And because the science is reaching a state where it is becoming more and more difficult for a man to consider that the chances took place. There is a scientist, a mathematician of high order and cosmologist by the name of Nye. He has written a book together with is somebody similar. And they have mathematically